Do you want to know how to find an acting agent in Toronto? Well, I'm going to give you 3 steps for finding and landing an agent in film and television. Welcome back and hello! If we haven't met already, my name is Olivia Daniels. I've got a series of videos in the film and television world. Why? Because I work in it full time. Today's video is for those of you who have decided to pursue the craft of acting in the film and television world on a professional level, and have some sort of acting on camera experience already. If you don't have any experience in the film and television world, it's still possible for you to get out there. It's just gonna be a little more challenging. And we want the odds in your favor, right? If you are still deciding if this career path is for you, I've got some other videos to maybe prep you a little better. So all of those videos are designed to give you an idea so you don't go in blindly, because I think that's kind of been the theme that's been happening. The more you know, the better prepared you're gonna be, the more confident you're gonna come across and stand out in this crazy competitive business. In a lot of my videos, I state that I am from Toronto, Canada, so from wherever you're watching, things could be slightly different, but if you're Canadian, you've come to the right place. Number one, go to the ACTRA website and make a list of the agencies you want to apply for. I know it can be tempting to send out a package to everybody on the list, but what I would suggest and what I've personally done is do it in batches. So I'd say like 4 to 5 each time. This way, if you get feedback, you can apply it to the next batch. I want you to be able to recover. I want you to learn throughout the process. I don't want you to just be impulsive, because this is a business and it just takes time to learn everything. But you're doing the right thing, you're here, you're taking the necessary steps, so I commend you for coming to the right place. So again, I have to stress the importance of not mass sending out packages, emails, because each agency has, pay attention, some agencies want the packages mailed out, some only want email submissions. This is kind of a test for them to see who's actually listening and reading and paying attention to instructions, because if you can't follow simple guidelines on how to apply to their agency, they're gonna be worried to send you out on auditions, or at least I would. You know what I mean? So I'm someone that values customization, personalization, little details. Like, if you take an effort to learn anything extra about me, I'm over the moon, and then I'm more likely to help you. So if you are applying to a specific agency, we're gonna stick with like the 4 or 5 at a time, right? Look up, if you are applying to the voice department, look up the agent's name in the voice department. If you are wanting to be with a specific agent because, say, your friends are with them and they're always working, look up the agent's name and direct the cover letter and address the information to that agent, so maybe they will see it first. Because usually in agencies, headshot, resume information kind of circles around. But if you wanted to get to someone faster, I would suggest doing the research so it makes it to the right person, right? Another good thing to do is Google. Google is your friend, guys. If, say, you are applying to me and I recently won an award, if you want to address that cover letter and start off with, "Congratulations on your Oscar, Olivia." Immediately, I see that you've taken the time to put in that extra detail. I mean, I value that, doesn't mean everybody will, but it's a nice icebreaker as well. Just remember, you want something from them, but at the end of the day, you guys are both need to be on the same page, because as much as you want them, they need you as well, because they need talent, assuming they have spots in their roster and a requirement for your look. Number two, what do you send out to your agent? You need to work backwards. So if your goal is to have an agent in the film and television world to represent you for those guest star roles, for lead acting roles, you need to know that they're gonna require a demo reel, a resume, a headshot, and a cover letter. So now I'm gonna just briefly go through all 4 of those, because you know almost every agent, if not every agent, is gonna ask for that. A demo reel is like a digital business card. It's footage of your work, on-camera work, cut together, ideally showing your best performances. So because you already have experience in the acting world. You can pay somebody to put together your demo reel. If you have an editing program like Premiere, Final Cut Pro, I think my first one, I put it together on iMovie. Everything is doable, but just remember, you want to shine. So if the quality isn't there, or it wasn't your best performance, I would leave it out. Be selective is my number one tip in that area with the demo reel, okay? And also in the beginning, I've seen people self-tape some stuff at home, just like I'm doing now, sort of thing. I'm not acting, but you know what I mean. And they've put in pieces of their performance from a self-tape in a demo reel. You gotta do what you gotta do, just take your time. And if you're debating on whether or not to put a commercial on a demo reel, say you've had a lot of success in the commercial world, I'm just gonna tell you this now. On your resume, on your acting resume, the list of commercials isn't listed. So I have like an asterisk and it says, list of commercials available upon request. Nobody, I don't wanna say nobody cares, but commercial world, film and television, seems to be a little bit separate to some extent. Even my acting agent now, I rarely go out for a commercial. It's strictly film and television world. So I would be wary of adding commercials to a demo reel, but ask around, use your judgment, and go from there. Headshots. I tend to do it every 2 to 3 years. It really depends if you change your look. Make sure you have a hair and makeup artist with you. Usually the photographer has like an in-house person or they call somebody, so you're not gonna have to specifically find your own people, but the hair and makeup is usually around $200 Canadian. Headshots, I would say, range from the $500 mark to $1,000 depending on who you go to. And remember, Olivia's general tip for anything in film and television is to make sure they've been around a while to make sure you are not scammed, okay? Please, please do your research. But at least now you know what the price ranges are. Obviously with time, it's gonna fluctuate, but that's kind of been the general range, I'd say in the last 10 years, so that gives you an idea. Also, I recently learned that if a production hires you and they want to drastically change your appearance, you as the performer can actually negotiate in your contract that they have to cover new headshots for you. I don't necessarily know if it'll work at the start of your career, but just being aware of that note, I think it's worth asking and fighting for, because headshots are not like $100. You're spending sometimes close to $1,000. So, okay, so what goes into a cover letter? I would say keep it brief, fun, name drop, you know what I mean? Do not use my name because agents do follow up. I've had my references called a number of times, so just throwing that out there. As for the resume, at the top of it, you're gonna have your specs. So your hair color, eye color, weight, your contact info, anything that you need, shoe size, you know, quick info. You can look up plenty of examples online of what an acting resume looks like. This does not include any of your part-time jobs. This is all acting related. At the very bottom, you're gonna have your experience and then your skill set. So skills, I speak Polish. I did cheerleading, so I added that. I was a swimmer. I trained to be a lifeguard. So make sure whatever you put under these skills, you can actually do and not just do a little bit, because here's a good example. I did cheerleading throughout university. I got called into an audition and I put cheerleader in my skills. They wanted me to do a backflip. And never at any point have I ever been able to do a backflip because I was a flyer. So that means I had a group of 3 people and I would be the one getting tossed in the air. So there was a big mix up there. I mean, I did what I could, but I just felt like it was a waste of my time, and there is a little bit. So whatever your skill set is, just make sure you can do it and you can do it well, or don't put it. I'd rather you have less. Also, if you have a passport, dual citizenship, add that on there. That's important. Languages, dialects, dance experience, all that is excellent. So under your experience, all your classes, on top of that, remember I have that asterisk with list of commercials available upon request. No one's asked. Then I have my theater experience up above that, and then my acting credits up above that, and then of course my general specs. I know I did that backwards, but I just went through what would be easier for you to fill out from the top to the bottom to the top. Number three, what to look for in an agent. Understanding, communication. You have to know if they've got the experience and the connections also with the casting directors. Here's an example. I was with an agent, let's say 5-6 years ago. She had her connections, she was fine. Then she decided to retire and her assistant took over her roster. And although I maybe even got along better with this assistant than my previous agent, she just didn't have the clout or the quote unquote experience to get me out there. So for me going out once a week, now it was once every 2-3 months. And that was alarming. Eventually I had to part ways, but it just goes to show you that just to have an agent, just to have it, doesn't even mean you're gonna get in the room. So make sure whoever, just like with all my other examples, make sure they've been around a while, because it takes time to cultivate relationships, especially with casting directors. I mean, I feel kind of bad saying that, because if you're starting out or just like, you know, got your foot in the door, it's hard for you to get experience too. And that's not to say you shouldn't trust in someone that's new. I just want to lead you in a direction where you're more probable to get auditions, because auditions are your chances to get those roles. No auditions, no chance. When you're looking for an agent, this is also the time to mention if you do any extra, which is background work or stand-in. With the extra work, not all agents like that, because it can become a conflict if you get featured and then you want to go audition for that show. It just turns into drama. So I am somebody that if I did that, I would just share it. There's no shame. You need to make money. And what better way to make money than being on set where you want to be? Because there's always opportunities that you're going to get chosen. They're going to give you a line, which is another credit on your resume. I mean, that's always the chance. It's very rare, but I've seen it happen. If your agent doesn't understand that you do extra work or stand-in work, or they don't want you to do that, are you okay working as a server or a bartender or a waitress or in sales somewhere else or at home from your computer? Like, you kind of have to make a judgment call. I personally, at this point, if somebody told me I couldn't do something, I would not sign with them, because I need to make money too. Because even if I book one acting day every single month of the year, which if that happens to you, amazing, congratulations, that's still under the living requirements for my lifestyle. So that's where that communication and understanding with your agent and being on the same page comes into play. Do not sign with an agent because you're just desperate to have an agent. Like I said before, you can have an agent and not go out. And now you've closed yourself off from all those other agents that maybe if you took another week or two, you could have been a better match. So just take your time. This is like the crucial, critical time. Your career could go from here to here real quick, or it could just be right here. And make sure you guys understand how you're gonna be communicating. Is it just through phone calls? Is it through emails? Is it both? Where are the checks gonna be sent to? Is it your place or their place? How much commission are they taking? Usually here in Canada, Toronto, it's around 15% around, okay? Sometimes some charge 20. Just remember two things. No one can guarantee you work or auditions, and if they do, run. And number two, you do not need to pay an agent anything. They make money when you make money, and it's never, ever some other way, okay? So there's no emailing fee. And remember, you're asking them questions just as much as they're asking questions of you, because you want to make sure they are a good fit for you and your lifestyle as well. Because you're going to be emailing, you're going to be talking, and if you don't get along, it's going to be a hard life, boys and girls. This video has helped you out. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and stay here for more information. Hey friend, it's Olivia Gadanets. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you're a subscriber, because I get to then see you every single Tuesday. Take care.